For the second day in a row, a federal district court judge has blocked U.S. President Donald Trump's third, stricter and indefinite attempted travel ban from coming into effect. Related Trump to dead vet's wife, he knew what he was signing up for. Maryland District Court Judge Theodore Chuang ruled in favor of the International Refugee Assistance Project and the American Civil Liberties Union, ACLU, and against the U.S. President Donald Trump regarding the president's September 24 executive order. The ban attempted to heavily restrict citizens from Chad, Iran, Libya, North Korea, Somalia, Syria and Yemen, as well as certain Venezuelan officials and their families, from entering the country. Chuang ruled that the order violated parts of the First Amendment and exceeds the president's delegated authority under the Immigration and Nationality Act to suspend the entry into the U.S. of classes of immigrants and non-immigrants. The judge also wrote that Trump's string of tweets on the issue offered convincing evidence that the latest policy is an inextricable reanimation of the twice-enjoined Muslim ban that the former reality television celebrity called for on the campaign trail, and thus is likely to be found unconstitutional. Particularly where, in August 2017, President Trump tweeted a statement that a method hostile to Islam, shooting Muslims with bullets dipped in pig's blood, should be used to deter future terrorism. There is no record of public statements showing any change in the president's intentions relating to a Muslim ban, he wrote. The judge was also unmoved by the administration's defense, insisting that no unconstitutional motives lay behind the consecutive Muslim bans because, during Trump's visit to Saudi Arabia earlier this year, he made various positive statements about Islam. Instead, the court noted that the Saudi speech did not in any way repudiate the president's prior intention to impose a Muslim ban. Additionally, the judge found that the inclusion in Muslim Ban 3.0 of two non-Muslim majority countries, North Korea and Venezuela, did not persuasively show a lack of religious purpose for the ban, but simply constituted a form of window dressing that would only affect a relatively tiny group of the country's respective populations, such as officials, versus the banned Muslim majority nations. Chang's injunction is more strict than yesterday's Hawaii ruling against the executive order banning entry only to those who can't demonstrate a credible claim of a bona fide relationship with a person or entity in the United States, much like the Supreme Court ruled in June on Trump's second ban. The administration claims that travel restrictions are necessary for U.S. national security. Chuang responded in his ruling that, to the extent that the government might have provided additional evidence to establish that national security is now the primary purpose for the travel ban, it has not done so. The ruling only applies to Chad, Iran, Libya, Somalia, Syria and Yemen. U.S. officials can still ban entry into the U.S. by certain citizens from North Korea and Venezuela. The injunction from Maryland is also the more limited of the week's rulings, allowing some of the new restrictions to take effect, such as those affecting people who lack a credible claim of a bona fide relationship with a person or entity in the United States. The Justice Department is expected to appeal both rulings, meaning this version of the travel ban may also be headed for the Supreme Court. No matter how many times the administration tries to dress it up in a different outfit, it's still a Muslim ban, said Maryland plaintiff Becca Heller, director of the International Refugee Assistance Program. We will continue challenging it until this cruel and senseless policy is indefinitely blocked. We've cleared our schedules.